Eight teams began their quest for the All-Cup, and now just two teams remain. The Whitby Steelhawks finished the regular season 13-1, their only loss by a goal to these Oshawa Outlaws. Happy Championship Easter Sunday from the Toronto Rock Athletic Center. We're live for the All-Cup Championship game between the Outlaws and the Steelhawks. Time now, let's send it downstairs to the carpet. Mr. Rick Imus and our PA announcer, Matt Carrick.
Thanks to this time, we let those who are able, please rise and move your hats and join Rick Imus as he performs O Canada.
I want to thank Mr. Rick Imus for his continuing contribution, national anthem throughout the Arena Lacrosse League season. It is time to get down, get dirty, and get ready. One game remains for everything on the line. Lance Swin, of course, working with the usual suspects in JVI Productions. Thanks for joining us here on Easter Sunday. And I tell you, starting goalies for the Outlaws, it's going to be Action Jackson Brown, who gets the call. 2-0 record, his goals against just over 12. And for the Steelhawks, the number one goaltender in the league with the best goals against average, Caleb Martin. He comes in with a 1-0 record. He has been shutting the door. Officials for our championship game, another all-star of the all-star crew. Joel Firmhand Furman is the crew chief. He's joined by Simon D'Souza and, of course, Kyle Coulter. And as we get ready to go here, boy, we're back again after two outstanding semifinal games yesterday. Today, well, the Oshawa Outlaws haven't been to the final since the first year that this league was in existence. That's seven seasons ago. These Whitby Steelhawks, winners just 2 years ago. So they have been here before. You take a look at that Oshawa bench, of course, the coaching staff over there. Joe Hiltz is the head coach. His assistants are Jay Lee, Justin Warner, and Ryan McMichael. And at the other side, of course, the Whitby Steelhawks come in the top team. Head coach is Joel Johnson. He's been leading the ship. Assistants are Brad Reed, Ryan Duggerton, and Will Peschnick. And opening faceoff, the championship game is underway right here. These two teams split the regular season schedule. Matchup, of course, it was Whitby beating Oshawa 13-6. That on March 2nd, and then on January 13th. What a beauty. Last second goal gave Oshawa the win, 16-15 there. This, the rubber match, coming in, and it's for all the marbles. Keep an eye, of course, on number 21, Liam Osborne, with the ball right now. He is the captain, the leader, the hub. He is the man for the Steelhawks. Nikolai Ferris, also one of the big scorers on that team. And, of course, can't ever forget a member of the Fife Dog crew, Devin Pfeiffer, out there on the right side for the Steelhawks. If you look at the Oshawa Outlaws, you start with number 7, John St. John. He's the facilitator. He is the man in the middle. He's been leading his team in scoring. Working with him, of course, it's the Hegg brothers, Gareth and Ryan. Ryan handles the draws. Gareth the scoring, and early on defense, tight end. A good block there, pick set by Kyle Coulter, and Gareth Hay going to work. Tough angle there, going to try the wraparound. That's a beauty, and it's Josh Gilray on the board. 1-0 for the Outlaws. That's just good heads up lacrosse right there. The real yeoman work came from Haig. Beauty pass, but a tough angle. Good decision not to take that. And then airborne, that's a beauty crease dive from Gilray, who's got some spring in his step considering he's a 7-year vet in the Arena Lacrosse League. So Oshawa out to the start that they were looking for, of course. Oshawa winners over Six Nations, 23-9, and then Brampton, 19-14. They have righted the ship, and they are on a roll right now, averaging a league best 21 goals a game in the playoffs. They have been deadly. Whitby now going to work here, looking for the equalizer. Keep an eye on Romancic. That one knocked down, and Curtis Romancic does a little of everything for this team here. And when we had a chance to talk to both coaches, as that one gets lofted down, picked up, and it's Pfeiffer's going to try to go to work one-on-one, shot clock violation. Keys to the game for Oshawa, of course, talked about discipline being the number one thing, knowing the power play for these Steelhawks is outstanding. Cut Whitby's transition game. They like to run. Liam Osborne leads that parade. And, of course, composure. You got to, can't get too high, can't get too low. Got to remain on an even keel, according to head coach Joe Hill. Stop rebound, Jake Gilmore collects his own, trying to work his way in. Weaves through, and that one's stopped by Martin. And Martin now will move it up. And if you're Joel Johnson, you talked about finishing strong. That means an outstanding regular season means nothing if you don't bring it to the playoffs. They want to start the story and end the story right here with a championship. Also, the adversity that they have gone through all season has helped them become a better team, and they've looked that way throughout the playoffs as Nikolai Ferris gets stripped. And of course, discipline, stay out of the penalty box. The Outlaws have been killer with the man advantage, and they don't want to give them that opportunity. So that gives us a rundown, and now with possession, the Outlaws will look to work it up with Nick Webb. Webb has Conley on him, and a great job of forechecking, forces an 8-count. So some good defensive work there by the Steelhawks now, and they will go to work. Matt Boissonneau, another one of those all-round defenders slash offensive transition players for the Steelhawks. And, of course, Colton Lidstone out there. His bounce shot scooped up neatly there. And a quick outlet pass from Brown will move up the Outlaws, who struggling a bit to get over the timeline due to the good forechecking, and now they do, working it to the offensive end. It's going to be St. John. Give and go. Backhand try by Austin Murphy. Wide of the mark. Rebound collected. And now Atwood will reset with a fresh 30. Works it down to the far side. Murphy looking for some room. Kick over. Finds Haig. Haig underhand. Tried to go through the wicket. Stopped though by Martin. Martin, quick outlet pass. Sends away Morgan. And that's close to an over and back. Luckily, they may not have got that. But Lidstone to work now. Gives it back. And guess who? Liam Osborne. The captain gets his team on the board and ties it up. And I could go on and on to the break of dawn about Liam Osborne, but the things that he does, sets the screen there for Lidstone, wide open, cuts back in and picks the short side there on Brown. First goal of the game for Liam Osborne. His 8th goal of the playoffs. So he has been getting the job done. More importantly, that ties things up here. And this is kind of the way we expect this matchup to go along here. So no one's really surprised, as moving it up and doing a good job is Adam Peroni. Peroni, he'll get it and give way to Keenan. Keenan will work it on the left side. Ferris. Skip, Ozzy Osborne trying to get a step. Osborne attacking, and he buries another one. That's going to be a factor today, as Liam Osborne has brought his A game to the track. Second goal of the game, it's 2-1 for the Steelhawks. This is just relentless pursuit. You see Osborne gets that first step, and once he blows by Tagori, there's no catching him. And when you go airborne, you immediately, as the attacking player, have the advantage over the netminder, and sure enough, Osborne pockets his second of the game. Off the draw, it's going to be Devin Pfeiffer. He'll control wrong stick side, but he'll peel back out. And they'll reset the offense from the top, working half boards right side. We're at the 10.5 minute mark here. Thank you for joining us on Easter Sunday as Pfeiffer is going to try to swim his way closer, lets the shot go. Wickets closed though by Brown, and his quick pass will move up Blumbergs. Another one of those underrated players in Austin Blumbergs. He seems to be everywhere. Chris Atwood, he could be the X factor today for these Outlaws. Hasn't put up his usual numbers, but when you have a St. John out there, all you have to do is be open just for a little bit. And that little outlet pass lobbed up. Good job to get it over the timeline. Lidstone now, full head of steam. Going to cut back in. Lidstone, great toe save. Brown at it again and comes up big for his team. Ferris tracks down that loose ball. Fresh 30 now to work with for the Steelhawks. They'll kick it back out. Jeff Fernandez back in the lineup. Congratulations to the newly married Jeff Fernandez. Lidstone now. He'll fake one way, go the other. Has some room now. They close that off. He'll weave through. And going to be a penalty. And the Outlaws are going to get saddled with an illegal cross-check. First power play of the game is going to go to the Whippy Steelhawks. So once again, if you followed the Arena Lacrosse League, you know how important special teams is. And you can see here, Lidstone just does a good job and great team effort as Ryan Nolan in there to close it off. But that was a cross check in the back and to work on the power play. And when you look at the numbers for the Steelhawks, they have struggled just a bit, just 29% here in the playoffs, their power play. But forever deadly, and they only needed to work one game. That shot from Ferris from way out, stopped by Brown. Brown will collect it. He'll flip, and Chris Veltman now will be tasked with getting it over the timeline. Lofts that one up, and that's going to go up and off the screen. So that'll give it right back to the Steelhawks with just over a minute and a half to play in the power play. So Pfeiffer out there with Ferris. Osborne settling in down on that right crease. Lidstone's going to filter out to that right shooter spot, leave the Fife dog at the top. They'll work it around. Keenan down on that left crease, and they'll give everyone a touch here before they go to work. 10 on the shot clock. Going to work now. Fife dog looking in. Ferris walks in. Great save, Brown. Veltman left that and did a good job not to do anything with it. That pass lopped it up. Josh DeGore going to try to run under it, but it's intercepted. And Sturles does a good job. One quick pass back in the offensive end. And a minute to work with here with a man advantage. Osborne, he's going to size it up. You better not give him that much room. He'll take what the defense gives you and then take a little more on the end. Pfeiffer, he'll inch his way in, try to gap that box. You see Veltman with a foot in a crease. He's really sagged back on that side. Lidstone, and Veltman made a great save. Another block shot. Tagori tried to knock it away. Shot clock right on. That one picked up, and Veltman. And that's going to be a tripping penalty, and it doesn't matter how it happens, accidental or not, a trip is a trip. And with 25 seconds left in the Oshawa penalty, Lidstone is going to go for tripping and nullify that power play. So 25 seconds, it will be a power play, the first one for the Outlaws. So in the meantime, between time, we'll play some 4-on-4 lacrosse right here, and going to work is Haig, Gareth Haig, looking to turn the corner. He's going to let that sidearm go. Great save by Martin. Had to go a long way with that right pad to make the save. St. John fakes the shot, ducks in. St. John, boom. Oh, great save. And St. John had the corner. Crease dunk. Five slam-a-jamma for Mr. Gareth Haig right there as he ties the score at 2-2. So two goals for the Outlaws, two crease dives, and you can see here, because it's not easy to beat that Caleb Martin fella, I tell you that, but going around and then having the presence of mind to dunk it on the one side by Haig, that's his first goal of this championship game, his ninth goal of the postseason. So when I tell you, forever dangerous, those Haig brothers. And give me a chance, of course, to send a shout out to the Haig posse, who is here and in full effect as they are just below me here, our booth up top. Good crowd on hand here for Easter Sunday championship game. We're under 7.5 to go and tied up course, all our games, the Arena Lacrosse League games, can be seen on the JVI Network on YouTube. Peroni now to work. So penalty over now, and the Steelhawks are going to have to kill some clock here. Just under a minute and a half in the penalty. They'll try and burn 15 more seconds off the shot clock. Then Oshawa will get a chance with the man advantage. Goodchild. Tyler Goodchild has been instrumental for this team, of course. And Ryan Nolan will take it from him, but right as the shot clock goes. And Niall Sear now over the timeline. Like to send a special shout out to the healthy scratches from both teams. I know it's a tough pill to swallow when you work hard all season and then don't get the call in the final game, but know that the Arena Lacrosse League appreciates you and everything you've done. We wouldn't be a league without you, so make sure you know you're appreciated. Power play to work at the top. Murphy, underhand BB from Garrett Haig, and he is in the house. Power play goal for the Outlaws. Haig's second of the game, and it's a 3-2 lead for Oshawa. So this is just well executed. He'll gap the box perfectly, and look at that angle. Changes it, goes to the underhand. It actually went through the legs there of Jordan Stouris and passed Caleb Martin for the third goal of the game for the Outlaws. So, of course, when you look at coming into this game, the playoffs, Whippy Steelhawks defeated Oshawa 16-14 in a tight one, and then a thriller yesterday in the semifinal against the defending champion Toronto Monarchs, 13-12 the final there. That was a beauty, and off that scrum in the neutral zone, the Outlaws come away with it, and Millsap now will hold steady on the half boards, give way to Haig. So Gareth Haig been instrumental so far in this game offensively for the Outlaws, as he works that half board. It's going to try to dip in, looking for someone. Kicks it over, Chris Atwood. Atwood now has some room. Atwood sized it up. Haig now, he'll let it go. Right on, stopped by Martin. Loose ball scooped up. Boissonneau. Matt Boissonneau is going to do a good job reversing, and one pass will send away Keenan over the timeline. And the Steelhawks now will look for an advantage and the equalizer with 5.5 to go. Trent Boyd, always good for a highlight or two. Keep an eye on him. He is the X factor on the Whitby side of things. I talked about Chris Atwood. Well, I tell you, Trent is the guy on that side that wields the X. I asked for a highlight. He gives me a crease dive, and we're tied 3-3. Trent Boyd, one of the best athletes in the Arena Lacrosse League, and I tell you, he's got a number of tricks in his bag. And that just being one of them, we'll see what he has. If he's uncorked that early in this one, be prepared, because he usually gives us plenty of highlight material to work with. Battle with Ryan Haig as he does a good job. Blumbergs comes in to back up, and Veltman now will look to make a good pass. He's going to have to put his head down, swim his way over that timeline, and he doesn't do it. Instead of going north to south, he went east-west and coughed it up. That, of course, with the time officially at the five-minute mark. We will take our first official's timeout. We'll take a break. You're watching the Arena Lacrosse League Championship game here on Easter Sunday. We'll be back. back here at the track, as you see the officials, Joel Firm and Kyle Coulter, over there having a spirited conversation with the coaching staff for the Whitby Steelhawks. And if you know anything about Joel Johnson, you know that he's usually a calm, cool customer, keeps things pretty even keel. And I liked his response. I had a chance to chat with him prior to the playoffs, and what he said to me was, you know what, Lance, we haven't done a whole lot except win a handful of games. Then he decided, as we roll through these playoffs, he again said, you know what, we've done what we've wanted to do so far in the playoffs, but we need to finish the chapter. We need to close the book the right way, and I think that's the goal here today, as you see officials having a chat with the coaching staff, Joe Hiltz, Ryan McMichael and company over there, Jay Lee, and we're good to go here. Tied at 3. Championship game here. They're going to work at the Osborne. Osborne immediately on the attack. Kick out. Swing around to that left side. Looking for an opening. Lidstone. He's going to think better of it. Comes back. Brings it around. And he'll look for an opening. Gets a screen from Pfeiffer. Goes to the bounce. Stopped though. Lays there on the carpet. And no goal, as that was a push and not a pickup and finish. So good attempt by the Fife Dog. Nothing doing there, as I can't remember, I guess, since the Pfeiffers have entered the league, we haven't had a championship without one. And that says something good there. Gareth Haig. I think the Haig brothers are going to try and do something about that. St. John now. Kick out. Off the crossbar as Alex Simons, and he has been shooting the ball a ton in these playoffs. And a lot of that's been due to St. John, who was been able to feed the guys in the right place. That one knocked down and picked up. Good job there, but trouble as Weller does everything in his power to stay out of the crease, going back in. Now it's going to be Morgan. Morgan with numbers for the Steelhawks. Gets to a stick side. Morgan tosses it over and an ill-advised pass. Keenan trying to bail him out. Boyd does. Lost it. And it's picked up again. Now Boyd overran it. Instead, it's going to be Morgan that picks it up and gets roughed up on the double team. Whitby will get it right back. Storrs the flip, and here they come now. Romancic, keep an eye. 1 minute he looks like he's going to pull it out. Next minute he takes it strong and buries it. Boyd, work it around. Ferris, he's going to tee it up off the iron. Lidstone with the carom. Goes to the sidearm. Underneath. Gets his own rebound. Lidstone trying to go short side. Robbed, though, by Brown. Stuck out the right arm. And give me a little more of that. As Brown closed the door. And now Morgan going to quick zip it up to McNulty. McNulty, one hopper. Finds Simon. Swings it around to Murphy. Murphy, he'll size things up. Atwood, that's his spot. Trying to look in. They cover that down. Backhand lofted up too high for St. John. Carom, though, almost got a gift. Instead, it's picked up and going to be moved up. Leclerc, he'll work it, and it's Peroni. Peroni will put on the brakes now. Think better of it. Whitby will get into their offensive set here and look for the go-ahead. Fife Dog, they'll work it back and forth, left to right. Set up at the top with Osborne. He'll filter down to that crease right side. Zip, skip, finish. I like the zip skip finish right there. Nikolai Ferris with the finish, 4-3 Whitby. You want to talk about perfect execution right here. This is the way you do the tic-tac-toe. If you diagrammed it as a coach, beauty, no look. And that quick stick finish from a tough angle from Ferris. Boy, member of the Good Hands team right there. First of the game, he's got 3 postseason goals and the Steelhawks with a 1-goal lead here. We're under just 2.5 minutes, first quarter. Off the draw, Matt Boissonneau. Boissonneau, head of steam. Waits for a cutter, breaking in, Romancic. Good save by Brown. Keenan gonna try and get that, and through the crease, the call. So possession will belong to Oshawa, and they'll look to move it up into the offensive end. Noah Millsap doing a good job there. Gives way to Simons and St. John. St. John will swing it around. They'll work it Atwood. Right side has a little bit of room. They haven't been giving Atwood a whole lot of breathing room, I tell you that. They stay right on him. Trying to look, get it to Haig. That pass couldn't connect. Instead, Martin to Weller. Weller looking at the back door. Weller looking to attack. Transition. Weller shot right on. Stop. Rebound picked up Sear. Niles Sear is going to launch that in the gondola. I almost had that, but actually, no, I didn't. and it'll come back the other way. What? Are you questioning my hands? Is that, I got one yesterday. I mean, you know, what can I tell you? Just hoping for the best. One day I'll get a foul ball in a baseball game. One day. Ferris turning the corner, goes to the bounce. That goes up, touches the rafters, and out of play. Oshawa will waste no time. Sear will try to work it into the offensive end. Ferris will take him down. Sear, though, remains calm, cool, collected, has possession. And St. John now, well away from that dotted half circle. He'll work it to McNulty. McNulty looking for a screen. Gilmore gave him a screen and some. And that one right in the armpit. And Gilmore and Ferris exchange a couple words. Morgan teeters on that line. And now it's Osborne as we head to the final minute here, quarter number one. Osborne. Zip it across. Looking for Osborne. Gets it back again. Osborne goes to the shovel. That just wide. No reset on the play. Keenan will scoop that up. Has a chance. But interference the call. And a tough break as good child was bad child there. And costs his team possession. That pass. Good job by Haig to go airborne. Conley all over him. Simons working it in. That one sent over. Gilray takes a cross check. Dives. Great save there by Martin. As he shrugged his shoulders, kept that ball out. Whippy now will move it over the timeline with Boissonneau. They will hold now for the final shot of this quarter. It's a whole lot. Net empty. Martin has left and vacated the premises. Lidstone. 5 seconds on the game clock. Gotta go. Gotta work, Fife Dog. Gotta go now. Whippy. Kick out. Lidstone. Shot is blocked. Great defense by the Outlaws. 15 minutes. Championship final. Has not disappointed. We'll be back with the second after this short break. Welcome back as we get set for second quarter action. A very good championship first quarter. 4-3, the Steelhawks leading here. And off the draw, that's going to be a violation. Give possession to the Outlaws. Of course, if you're watching on your screen, flip the switch, go in different directions. Of course, the Outlaws in their road dark blue uniforms. The Steelhawks in their home house whites. And just in case it wasn't clear to you, Austin Murphy now working the right side half boards. He'll duck in, but too much on the Gilray screen. And it's picked up. And here come the Steelhawks now. Luke Keenan working one-on-one, kicks it out. Osborne trailing in, barges his way in. Lidstone's going to pick that carom up and swing it around to the top. They'll work it back to Ferris on the left. Ferris shot right on, stopped by Brown. Rebound popped up. Keenan had it but lost it. And now Farthing airs one out looking for Webb. Webb and Ferris in a race for it. And I'd have to give that one to Ferris for sure with the quick feet. But the quick feet don't matter if you don't have the hands to go with it. And a good job by Sturrels. But he gets roughed up. And a whole lot of great forechecking from the Outlaws. But Weller, great grab. Weller on the run, run, 600. What a save by Brown after a great grab by Weller. One-handed on the fly on the wrong stick side. Atwood will set it up now. Get it to St. John, has some room. Dumps it off inside McNulty, and he hit the pad. He hit the pad. He had the wide open net, but he rung it off of Martin's pad. And Oshawa, good job to collect that. Get another clock. Atwood, that's his shot. Right on, but he'll get his own rebound. He'll try to go again, kick it out. Smothered. Backhand try. St. John. Simons, point blank, wide. Steelhawks dodge a bullet and a half right there. And they'll work it up into the offensive end with Rowan Kelly. Kelly will look, zip it over, finds Fernandez. He'll do a big hard curl and keep it on that side, working to Lidstone. Lidstone ducks in, trying to get a step. Had Fernandez on the doorstep, couldn't do anything there. Good child, diving, good child, and it's a good goal. So he went from good child to bad child, back to good child again as he picks up his first here of the championship. And it's a 5-3 lead, and you can see here just some good work. Good child never gave up on the play, diving there. And once again, to beat these goaltenders, you really do have to have some sort of advantage. And a great job there by Goodchild to use every inch he had to pick up his first goal of this game. 5-3 Whippy. Now, this is where Oshawa has to be careful. You can't let Whippy get out to too big a lead because they're stingy. They don't give up a whole lot. And they have been known to play four steady quarters. So tough team to come back on. Simon steps into that one off the glove of Martin and out of play. And that will stay right here. Fresh clock to work with for St. John and company. Tried to duck in. Rock the house. Great move. St. John has some room. Duck it in one. Shovels it back, but it went off a defender. Stays in the zone and off a toe. And Martin's going to air it out. Now he finds Morgan. Morgan has Osborne. Ozzy, great save by Brown at that end there. Morgan's going to collect the rebound, keep the possession right here. But Jackson Brown keeping his team in it one more time. That quick shot from Keenan save. Osborne will collect it. Steelhawks all over these offensive rebounds and loose balls. They have been relentless. Trent Boyd ducking in. Boyd tried to flip it up. I don't know what he was going to pull out of that bag of tricks, but we know he was reaching for something. Webb will pick that up. He'll make a pass. They're going to have to try to regroup. Lidstone all over Tompkinson. Great hands there by Ryan Nolan, the cagey vet. And he's trying to duck his way through the double team. That's a tough double team, though. Lidstone and Leclerc, they close that up. Lidstone kicks that one down. Millsap's going to track it down. And he's going to have to work it. So no reset on the clock. Got to go the distance, just 5 seconds left. Going to have to let it fly. Gilmore will right on. And that one's stuck to Martin. Martin's going to air it right back out. Deep. And that one's tipped. Good defensive play by Austin Murphy as he played the cornerback position perfectly. But Ferris has Murphy. And Ferris couldn't get a handle on it to Sear. And then Sear tossed his stick. So Sear is going to the penalty box. And that was an easy call there as Niall Sear just tossed Nikolai Ferris' stick away. And, of course, that will get you at the very least 2 minutes. That's the case right there. You see the signal from crew chief, Mr. Firmhand Furman. So back to the power play for the second time go the Steelhawks, 0-for-1. And they've got Ferris Keenan on the left, Pfeiffer's at the top. You've got Osborne and Lidstone on that right side. So the power play unit, safe to say, deadly. And a good save by Brown as Osborne teed that one off. This one's aired out to Gorey, going to try to run under it. Quinn Hyland does a good job playing interference, and he'll get it. One pass, move it up to Ferris. Whippy with a two-goal lead here, trying to pad that, create some space between them and these Outlaws. Outlaws, of course, comeback specialist. Let's don't twister stop, though, by Brown. Veltman's going to pick that up, and he's going to try to work it up. Got to go north-south. Good pass there, and teetering on the line. Weller tried to push Ryan Haig over, but Haig did a great job to stay in the offensive end and settle things down here. Going to look to kill some time. St. John, a minute left in the penalty. He's going to go for that little hop there, and Kelly's going to try to chase him. That one right on, stays right here. So like the master he is, St. John will get his team another 30 to burn here with 50 left in the penalty. I know it's tough to plan something like that, but it takes some skill just to get the shot on net from that angle. Simons, double team, all over him. Peroni, Leclerc, going to try to work him over. Gilray runs the safety, and no call. Martin with a great save and a quick pass to Weller. Weller's going to eye the back door. Has Boyd. Weller. Boyd. That one and almost knocked by Tompkinson. Millsap going to flip it up. Hold on to it. Great move there to elude a defender. And Millsap going to put on the Jets, working it to the offensive end. Final 10 seconds of the penalty. Millsap, why not? He's been working that hard. He'll peel back out. Job well done by Millsap. And now Farthing. He'll dump it, but a great job by Haig. Oh, boy, extra effort. Gareth Haig, keep that one in the end. Seven on the shot clock. And Haig, because he deserved it. He deserved that goal from start to finish. Gareth Haig with his third goal of this championship game. Now, I like where this replay starts, but the whole thing was keeping that from going over the timeline and then having the presence of mind to come change the angle, go to the underhand instead of an overhand to beat Martin. Boy, Gareth Haig is feeling it today. We've got a 5-4 game. Off the draw, Boissonneau's gonna scoop and go. Pass off, finds the Fife dog, he'll slow it up. So Whippy now will look to regroup and answer back as the Outlaws have trimmed the deficit now back to one. Swing around. Boyd has some room. Let's see overhand go. Trent Boyd. Talk to me now. Trent Boyd, second of the game for Boydie. And you can see here just a good shot. When I had a quick chat with him prior to the game, I won't lie, I asked him for a highlight. Thought he was a little quiet in yesterday's semifinal. So I expect him to step front and center and do his thing here today, and so far he is not disappointed. Off the draw, this time it's Morgan that's going to control. He'll set it up, and Veltman will tiptoe over the timeline. And the Outlaws will set things up now in the offensive end. St. John, isolated one-on-one. You're going to need some help. Beauty backhand. Gilmore. Gilmore able to tiptoe all around, and he rung it off the pad. Now it's going to be Osborne trying to check it out. Osborne just couldn't get to that ball in time, and it'll be the Outlaws back the other way looking to chip away at this two-goal deficit right now. Haig. Swings it around. Atwood looks for an opening. 10 on the shot clock. Atwood. Give and go. Beauty, but Murphy couldn't hold on. So that, of course, will take us to our officials' timeout. Give us a chance to send out a few shout-outs as we roll through this championship game. Certainly like to shout out the C3PO crew, the Rock Route Roadies, as they are in the house here today. Thank you for joining us. The Zulians for their continuing support. I already threw out the Haig Posse, and now we got to add the Fife Dog crew to that. Always a hello to them. We'll take a quick break. We'll be back with more of the second after this. Set to go here as our producer Chris was just getting a little busy with the little MJ there, but we settled him down. He's back to work now. That's what happens when you have a wave or two. You have a little flashback. Can't help yourself. Steelhawks to work in the offensive end. Fernandez shot. That one is steered aside by Brown. Rebound picked up and going for the crease dive again. This one was in the crease, so nothing doing there. Sear now has St. John backdoor. Two on two. Sear will keep it underhand. Went overhand and over the net. Rebound now gobbled up. Here come the Steelhawks and Matt Boissonneau. Boissonneau into the offensive end now. He will send it over, and it's Osborne. He'll attack as usual. Curls out this time, and he'll survey the situation. Ferris. Lidstone. Ducks in. Good defense on him by Webb. Looking for the underhand. Pfeiffer telegraphed that. It got partially deflected. Osborne battling behind that net. Dying seconds in the shot clock. Good job there by Millsap, and he'll work it up to Blumbergs. Blumbergs will look at that half boards left side. That's where it all starts with St. John. Him and Murphy working well together. And they'll filter the rest of the offense out. Haig out there now. He'll send it over to Simons. And they'll work it to Atwood. Atwood zips it across. No look. St. John couldn't connect there. And now that pass, Rowan Kelly does a good job to knock it down. Atwood, the only defender back. Numbers for the Steelhawks. And a bouncer from Conley, I would say ill-advised on your wrong stick side with Trent Boyd there on his right stick side waiting for it. Either way, Gilray on the run. Goes back where he came from. It's a 6-5 game. How about Josh Gilray, second of the game? He really has come to life in this postseason. He has stepped up here, and you can see Atwood, a good job, no look on the fly. The real skill here is Gilray moving to his left but shooting back to his right, and that's how he beat Martin. Martin, who was doing the shift, but that ball went in the corner he left. 6-5 game here for the Steelhawks as the Outlaws continue to keep it close. Boissonneau dominating now in that faceoff circle. Couple of the two best faceoff men in the Arena Lacrosse League, and Haig and Boissonneau, and Keenan now isolated on the half boards left side. Gets a step. Keenan goes in. What a save by Brown. Oh my. Close that off. That pass though, not the best, and he'll give it right back to the Steelhawks now as they will work it up over the timeline with McKinnon. Good child. Looking for an opening. He'll zip it across. Lidstone will find the Fife dog. Pfeiffer tries to go underneath. 10 on the shot clock. Gotta go. Keenan on the doorstep. Boyd backhand try wide. Rebound. Lidstone got to get a shot off. Cutting in. Keenan backhand. Beauty pass. Good shot. That one right on. Trying to get his own rebound. Battling with Veltman. Veltman in there, and scoop two will do just that as he will move it up for the Outlaws and loft it up, but then he gives it right back. No over and back, and I think they're saying that it was touched, and I think a good job by the officials. They'll get together. Of course, three different angles on the play, and from what we saw, clearly it was not an over and back because it was a defender that had touched the ball. So I like the way our officials crew has gotten together. They will converse, and they'll make sure the call's right. If you take a look there, as you can see, we couldn't catch it on our part due to the way things were angled, but it was clearly. And when you have three officials and there's no concrete conclusion, you do what you're supposed to do and you call a draw ball. I think that's one of the things a lot of fans and coaches forget, that number one, the officials are the only guys out there that are continuing out there the entire game. Nobody else is. They are. The only breaks they get are the media timeouts. Secondly, they're the only ones out there that have to be perfect. Coaches, they can make mistakes. Players can make mistakes. But when an official makes a mistake, it's a huge problem. We're all human. They're out there. This is the best Arena Lacrosse League crew, along with a good 6 to 8 others. And they're challenged. Each game is differently. So hats off to them. They stay strong. And boy, I tell you, got to have some thick skin. Ferris looking to create some space here. One goal game. Work it down. Fernandez, kick it back out. Osborne will work to Lidstone. Great swim move. Lidstone barrels in, but that's a crease call as he was expecting the contact. Now it's Sear on the run. Sear puts on the brakes and had it pop out, but probably best to reset anyway as he gives way to Simons. Simons, McKinnon chasing him down. He'll kick it back out to Murphy. Murphy has St. John. St. John, he'll duck in. Underhand, stop though. Great job by St. John to change that angle, but Caleb Martin read that like a novel. McKinnon on the run. Fife dog, give and go. McKinnon, shot stopped by Brown. And that'll stick. Brown will keep that. And both these netminders standing tall here and keeping their teams in it. It's a 6-5 game. Haig will control here. He has St. John, and they'll work that left side. Quick pass, Atwood. Atwood had that one knocked down. Good job by McNulty. He'll kick it back out. 6 on the shot clock. Atwood one-on-one. Going to have to create his own shot. Steps back. You can see the accuracy, but the basket right there to cover the wickets. And now Weller does a great hesitation move. Gets it over the line. Works it up. It's Keenan. Keenan had a notion. Zips it. Finds the Fife dog. He'll curl back out. And they'll reset the offense here. Osborne gets a step. Osborne on a quick shot. Ozzy, Liam Osborne one more time. Captain is in the house for the Steelhawks as he pockets another. That's his third of the game, and it's 7-5 for the Steelhawks. So when I tell you Liam Osborne is constantly on the attack, I kid you not, he looks for an opening, and the skill that he has is he takes what the defense gives him and works around that. So a good counter puncher, but also extremely aggressive and not afraid to take that strong. Romicic and Morgan collide. Those are two solid bodies. Tagori picks it up. He's in some trouble, and Roan Kelly pops him, and it goes into the Oshawa bench. So good defense there. If you're watching, you young lacrosse players out there, cross check. That's the best check in the game. Most effective. Boyd ducks in, rolls. Boyd on the underhand, right on stop. Tagori battled for Fernandez, took it from him, and Osborne backed him up. Another possession for the Steelhawks. That one in the gondola as it got partial stick check. And Oshawa holds steady on the defensive end. They'll head back up as we head into the 2-minute warning. Murphy. He gets the screen, or a token one anyway. Works that over to Haig. Haig gets a step. Haig puts on the brakes, curls around. Looking to zip that back out. Finds St. John. Looking down low. Was trying to find Gilmore. Couldn't handle the pass. And a good outlet from Peroni. Finds Ferris. Ferris zips it across. Look it in. Pfeiffer had a man in Morgan. Morgan's going to head off to the bench. Ball loose. Ferris battling for it. Pfeiffer teetering on the line. He'll make the turn. Fife dog, but 8 on the shot clock. Let's it go, that one. Right on, stopped by Brown. Loose behind the net. Pfeiffer battling for it, but it's going to go into the crease and belong to the Outlaws as Boyd getting tangled up there. And now it's going to be Webb that'll work it over the timeline into the final minute here of this first half. St. John trying to close the gap. Delayed penalty coming to the Steelhawks. Simons, bullet. That will go up out of play. And so a penalty will be assessed here with 49.5 seconds left. Looks like it's going to go to the Steelhawks. And despite some protest, it's going to be a roughing call, and it's going to go against Riley McKinnon. So the Outlaws are going to go to their second power play, but in the meantime, between time, the Outlaws will call timeout. We'll take a quick break. You're watching the Arena Lacrosse League Championship game on the JVI Network. Set to go here as the Oshawa Outlaws will go to work with a man advantage. A roughing call to McKinnon gives the Oshawa power play a chance here to close the gap, trailing by two, trying to get one at least before the end of this half. Same power play unit out there, Gilray and Simons on the right side. Murphy's at the top, St. John and Haig on the left. They go to work now. Quick shot, execution, perfect. Alex Simons on the money. Didn't take long. Pick up their second power play goal of the game. And you can see here, that's just simple fundamental lacrosse, gapping the box. And a good job. Simons was ready to shoot. Short side. On the money for Simons. Simons first of the game. That's his eighth goal of the postseason. And now the Steelhawks control with Boissonneau. Surprised they haven't called a timeout yet. And sure enough, on cue, they do call a timeout. That will, of course, give us a chance just to zip through a few things. And when we talk about these two teams, of course, let's congratulate the All-West champions. The Blackfish defeated the Shooting Eagles two games straight, 13-12 the score in the first game, 16-11 the final in that game. The Women's Championship, the Arena Lacrosse League East, the Skyhawks defeated the Firebirds 6-3 there. And the U-22 Championship, the Loggers over the Outlaws 12-6 the score there. This will give me a chance, of course, to thank a few people, including the coaches. So Ron Moser Henry, Jamie Dubrick, Joel Johnson, Joe Hiltz, Darcy Palace, Bobby DeBrone, Joe Sullivan, Jeff Dowling, and of course their assistants. This league would not be what it is without your guidance, tutelage, and expertise. 26.1 seconds to go. You can see that on the clock. Whippy's going to play here for the final shot. Looks like there's a two-second differential. So that means Caleb Martin's going to stay in his net. 2 seconds, a whole lot of time in lacrosse. So Lidstone is going to be at the top. They're going to let that game clock tick down, and then they'll go to work. So 10 on the shot clock. Here go the Steelhawks, looking to extend their lead. Pfeiffer gets a screen, duck in. Works it around. Let's go inside. Keenan! That's the way you do it. One to the other. End to end. That's why these two teams are in a championship. Perfectly done at both ends as Pfeiffer gets it where he should. And Lidstone to Keenan on the doorstep. And he pockets it. And a big goal for the Steelhawks. Keenan's first with 3.8 seconds left, and I would expect that both teams would be happy with that, but give the Steelhawks credit for the answer after a perfectly designed play. 30 minutes at the track have been played. Championship game. It's going to take 30 more to determine this year's champion. We'll take a break. We'll be back with the third quarter after this. Coming out of it, Bragg steps into one. Longboat, good save. The outlet is tossed down there. This may have a chance. Longboat scores! Jackson Longboat finds the back of the net from his own net. So you could say that was an accident, but it wasn't. And hats off to the veteran Ryan Masters as he points down in acknowledgement to Longboat. Longboat, oh, he planned this. That was perfectly placed. Two hopper into the top corner. And for the first time this season, I got to put a goal mark by the goaltender. Just some good work here by Pedwell as he was initially thought about that crease dive from behind the net, but as you can see, space opened up there and good composure to take his time, size up Haynes and find that near corner. Stick side, takes a good hard check. Oakley Thomas looking for the dunk and Tanner Buck. The Buck stopped right there. But a lot of extra work there. Oakley Thomas with a great job on the cross check, but that ball got to Tanner Buck and he did exactly what he needed to do. You can see there, just a good job, McGregor Allen finding Vern Hill, always quick on the release. And Vern Hill, goal number 7 on the season, and more importantly, puts a halt to that 4-goal run by the Snipers and trims the lead now to 5-2.
And you can see Sunderland finding that hole down to the middle. Nice little fake. And he finds an opening down low. And a 2-on-1. Eistrat with the finish as he tiptoes right at the top of the crease, avoiding that line.
Kyle Pedwell doing a good job of getting that ball over to Whiteford in plenty of time. And he beats Longboat in the short side. So it'll be Jaminski against Haynes. Jaminski finds the back of the net. I think unlike hockey, clearly in lacrosse, the breakaway favors the offensive player. Not 21st goal of the season, and just a good job by Whippy to share the ball, find the open man, reach out and tuck it in that far corner on the dive. Filter his way in and that pass gets intercepted in transition. Vandersholm in alone. A big save by Nagy. Shrugged his shoulders, kept that one out. Initial target, but boy, quick on that right there. As you can see, good pass dumped in, and he certainly was. So a good quick stick finish. You talk about lucky and a good job going to that open spot and point blank range. Not much of a chance for Hrushka on that one. Justin Porga with back-to-back goals.
Shot and a reset, but possession for the Steelhawks. Now they're in all alone. Huge save by Woods. Spinning off a check there and just seeing space and working with it. A few fakes and dropped the goalie, Jackson Brown, and made the move. As we take another look at it, and Jackson Brown was already watching his pass. And if not for that hit, Aaron Walker might have had a chance on an empty cage.
Here we go.
follows Patty. Follows top corner.
Efficiency, that kid. He's efficient as he buries his second of the game. Parker Pfeiffer with his eighth of the season. His first today, and you talk about this offensive output. We'll be joined by Joe Hiltz. How about that hand and finish? That was a beauty. Alex Henry pulling that one out of his back pocket.
Over to St. John. He circles out to the top, looking for a hole. Backhand pass back over to the side. Shoots and scores as Gilmore gets things going on a nice pass from St. John. Takes it. St. John, who had that last goal, he drives to the net, scores.
Back at it here at the Toronto Rock Athletic Center as we get set for third quarter action of the 2023-24 championship season here in the Arena Lacrosse League. Lance Wynn working alongside JVI Productions. We've been doing it the entire season. 14 regular season games for each team. Then, of course, everyone makes the quarterfinals down to four. That was yesterday. We are now down to two here today off the draw. Keenan, flip, Fife Dog, off the post. So right off the bat, Whippy starting things off here in his third with a little pep in their step. And Oshawa, good job defensively as Millsap's been all over that defensive end. Pass dangerously. St. John pivots, gets it over, and the Outlaws now will set it up. So both teams put together a solid first half. I think the difference was power plays, of course, very efficient with the man advantage are the Outlaws. They come in, and of course, they have a 2-for-2. Whitby 0-for-2 on the power play, but they lead by two here on the scoreboard. Conley had that one pop out and might want to work, make that pocket a little deeper. Doesn't look, looks more like he's playing field than box, so might want to do something with that. And either way, here comes Sear. Sear on the run. He'll peel off, stop, drop, set up, and it'll work now to McNulty. So just want to send a shout out while we have a minute to my man Ryan out there on the east side doing his thing, of course. Hopefully you're staying out of trouble, but I know you're probably not. That's my message to you, and look forward to the next time we can converse. And Boyd now will send it over to Lidstone. Lidstone looking for an opening, trying to turn the corner, dumps it off. Ducking in is good child. He loses it. Good defense by the Outlaws. Outlet pass on the run in the basket. It's Webb. Webb. Great save there by Caleb Martin. And Nick Webb had a couple of transition goals yesterday, and he was instrumental in their win. Not this time, no, as Martin puts a wrench in that plan. Boyd, skip pass. Ferris had that one deflect off Veltman, who made another good save. I think Veltman's save percentage this playoffs is probably about 800. And it'll be Lidstone now. Boyd inside. Osborne, what a save! Oh, baby! Someone put an APB out on that man, Brown. He should be arrested for robbery. Nolan now has it taken away, and that'll be an over and back. And Boissonneau will scoop that up. Osborne, fake. He's going to bull in. You can tell he got something to show here. Bounce shot stop. Rebound. Good child had a chance. Scooped up, though, and Romancic will peel out, and they'll reset with another 30. Goaltending a factor, and boy, Brown has stood on his head and some. Pfeiffer on the run. Fight dog sidearm. That never got through. Fernandez scooped up, though, and Harlech will do the dance, race around, and he'll carry it over the timeline. St. John. Outlaws trying to chip away here, trailing by two. We're early in this third quarter. Championship game. There is no tomorrow. Today's the day. Gilmore fakes the shot, ducks in. Gilmore, great save, sliding across. Martin moving well to his right. Pass up to Weller. Weller will wait. He's solo. Good transition defense from the Outlaws, and Boyd will set it up. Morgan's going to pressure him. Lidstone one-on-one with Tagori. Lidstone swims his way over. Lidstone, fake, bang! Talk to me now. Colton Lidstone buries it 9-6. Now you want to see some stick skills here, I tell you. Lidstone in close, fakes to that corner and goes right back to that same corner. That was the fake that Osborne used. The only difference was Brown read that one and made a great basket save. This time around, you saw Lidstone taking notes and made the adjustment, found the back of the net now, and it's a 3-goal lead. This game, of course, eerily similar to the one these two teams played earlier this year in a 1-goal win in which the Outlaws battled back from behind and ended up scoring in the final minute to win it. And Osborne now, again, on the attack. You see head goes down. Going to be a delayed penalty. Kick out. Great save, Brown. And rebound there. And fortunately, no one's knee or anything got twisted up. Awkward fall there. Probably should have blown that down immediately when I think it's Millsap that's in the bottom of that pile. And he's slow to get up, but fortunately, he's flexible. And he'll be flexible enough to head to the penalty box, because I think that's where he's going. So 0-for-2 in the first half with a man advantage. The Steelhawks, they will go to work now as, again, Millsap will head for a legal cross-check. So Whippy will set up their power play unit now looking to extend this lead here, and this would be a big kill if you're Oshawa and go a long way to helping the cause. Can't fall behind much more to these Steelhawks. Like I said before, they're awfully stingy. The only real lead that they've given up was to these Outlaws. Skip pass, boy, tried to quick stick finish. Couldn't find a mark there. Good job to corral it. Got to hurry here. Shot clock down. 4. That underhand again. Veltman, told you his save percentage is 800. He's stopped everything that's hit him. And what are we going to have here? We're going to have a delay of game, I think. Or they'll just clear the scrum and play on. And now Haig going to try to burn some clock. Gareth Haig one-on-one. Gets chased back out. Reverses, spins around again. Haig gets hooked, ducks in, gets two defenders, 3 now, and they'll finish their check. Interference, the call there, and an easy call as they took liberties with Gareth Haig there. And with just over a minute 6 here to kill in this penalty, it's going to go into the hands of John St. John, or to stick up. St. John down on the half boards, left side, that's his office. He'll work it out. Austin Murphy now will look to swing it. They're going to try to burn this entire clock down. And Whippy will not be in any hurry. Whippy in the lead, so they won't fight the clock at this moment. St. John tiptoeing around. Peroni all over him. And St. John, I don't even know. He took him down, but the ball has long since been out of his stick. And Conley all over him. And those two will collide on the way by. And now Pfeiffer will set it up. So a whole lot of barking going on from both sides. Probably best to save your tears for another day. Osborne, kick it out, Lidstone. They'll run that quick shot, stopped by Brown. Rebound, Fife Dog, fresh 30 now. Just 12 seconds left in the penalty. We're under 9 minutes to go here, third quarter. Pfeiffer, inch way, no look. Ferris going to bail him out. Penalty over. And Lidstone ducks in. That one deflected again. Veltman in the way. I don't know if Veltman should wear maybe one pad or something because he's been playing netminder. On the run. Simons dumps it over. Millsap off the post. Atwood is going to get a chance here. Dumps it off. Millsap through the crease. The call. And a late hit there. And that's going to cost someone 2 minutes somewhere. So I think it's going to be important. Both these teams have to understand, and when I say teams, I mean players. This is a crucial game, and penalties could be the difference here. So McKinnon is going to go to the penalty box. Outlaws, 2-for-2 with a man advantage, will get another chance here. And we'll get some clarification on the board. And it's a 2 minute slashing call. So Murphy at the top one more time. You see who's out there. The same power play unit that has worked this game and the last. So Haig and St. John, they'll work it. But as usual, you give everyone a touch, get a feel, get into this power play situation. Gilray, fake, kick out, skip. St. John, backhand, work it. Haig aired it out, looking for that top corner. Murphy will bail him out. 7 on the shot clock. Quick underhand, right on. That one lays there. And Steelhawks now going to have to work. Whole lot of spinning, zipped out. And Gonna have to hurry as Boyd, great job to get it over. Trent Boyd, good clock awareness there as he knew he was running low on time, and the Steelhawks gonna try to work some clock here. Lidstone, Tagore's gonna be all over him. Dump off, quick shot, good child, Radon. Rebound corralled, and here comes Nolan. So the Outlaws need a little something here as they head into the final minute of their power play. Got to do something, chip away at this lead. These Steelhawks get stronger as the game goes on. Atwood at the top this time. They'll work that interchange. That's his shot. Atwood let it go, but just wide of the mark. Goes up and out of play. And with 7:08 to go, that will take us to our officials' timeout. We'll take a quick break. You're watching the Arena Lacrosse League Championship game on the JVI Network. Back here at the Toronto Rock Athletic Center, of course, home practice facility for the Toronto Rock of the National Lacrosse League. The Arena Lacrosse League, of course, the official partners with the National Lacrosse League. Keenan to work as 30 seconds left in the Whippy penalty. They will try to burn that. And Osborne, the right man for the job if you want to talk about ball possession. 10 on the shot clock. He'll just lop that play to Karam, to Ferris, and yes, that was a planned play. Ferris will leave it in the corner. Good job killing 30. Just 6 seconds left in the penalty now. So Oshawa will work it up into the offensive end, and they'll set things up. Haig, he'll peel back up. 10 on the shot clock. St. John covered. He'll zip it over Gilray. 5 on the shot clock. Got to move. Trying to swim his way. Great defense, Peroni. And I can't believe Alex Simons just carried a defender on his back like a knapsack backpack and put it in through the 5-hole. Alex Simons, I don't know how he shed 2 defenders there on his side. Snuck it through the 5-hole. And you talk about giving your team a lift. Simons, as the penalty expired with his 2nd of the game, and it's 9-7. So you can't knock any of these guys. The effort's certainly there, and why not? They worked hard all season as Veltman puts a shoulder down working on Boisido, and a bit of a size differential there. As St. John now will set up. So see if Oshawa can build on their momentum here on a big goal from Simons. And they'll work it to St. John. St. John zips it over. That one's picked off. But a chance here as Blumbergs manages to regroup. 5 in a shot clock. Inside. Gilmore up down. And he faked one too many as Caleb Martin read it and stopped it. Boisino. We'll work it over the timeline. And Lidstone will set it up. Osborne. Farthing on him. Gets a screen. Osborne. 6 on the shot clock. Lidstone going to have to go to work here. He'll run through that offense. Sidearm right on. That's stuck to Brown and inside the pad. So a good hold by the Outlaws as they hold steady. And now Haig will set up the offense. Goal here would go a long way for this Oshawa team in closing the gap, only trailing by two. St. John over to Atwood. Atwood had an opening but couldn't get it cleanly. Underhand, bounce, Gareth Hank. He's got the Midas touch today. Everything he touches turning to gold. No goal on the play though, as there was a crease call. So they eliminate that goal, and too bad as the Outlaws though, but their defense continues to roll along and hold court. Millsap on the run. And that's one of those situations where head coach Joe Hiltz talked about composure, not worrying about the little things. Play on. St. John, flip. McNulty, bounce, stop. Rebound pops out. Loose. Steelhawks pick it up. On the move, they have numbers. 3-on-2 with Conley. Conley will send it to the middle. Big shot from Morgan that got blocked. It'll stay right here with Ferris. And Nikolai will hold up, stop, drop, and set up shop here. Steelhawks dodging a couple bullets themselves. Now it's the Fife dog. He'll look for an opening. All the way across to the left. Pfeiffer, dump over. No look. Keenan tried to quick bat that in, and it'll go up the other way. So the Oshawa defense has been real good in this third quarter. And hey, he too has been real good this quarter. Romanchich on him. Hagel swinging around, work at St. John. St. John again, dangerous pass. This time, no, he had a little extra zip on it. Gets it to Gilray. Gilray working to Gilmore. Boissonneau on him. Size differential. Boissonneau, good job there. That shot wide of the mark. It's going to be McKinnon that scoops it up off the boards. And on the way there, a little bit of embellishing going on. A little soccer action. And Fernandez going to get chased around. Dumps it off. Finds Osborne. Osborne had a notion, but the double team came. And now Boyd with the underhand right on. Osborne bodies his way in. Has two defenders on him. Boyd's going to hang around the outside, try to fish something out. And instead, it's going to be Blumbergs who had it, but he lost it. And now it's going to be Millsap that bounced off a check. Sorry, Haralek, and he's over the timeline. Good job by the Outlaws winning that battle for the loose balls. Time winding down 2.5 here in this third quarter. St. John. Haig. He'll sidestep. Work back where he came. Tried to let the sidearm go, but it got blocked. And now here come the Steelhawks. Full head of steam. On the run is Morgan, and he'll put on, I'm not sure if they were brakes, but certainly slow things up. And Ryan Haig, under no circumstances, a horse collar not going to be called. And a delayed penalty going to come here to the Outlaws. So Whippy now is going to work it and zip it over. But they'll attack any time over the top. And that goes up and out of play. So back to work with a man advantage. Go Whippy, who has struggled so far. 0-for-3 on the power play. But a chance here to extend this lead now to 3. And you can see there, I'm not quite sure what sport that isn't a penalty. So that would probably be more of a question. But either way, you know our officials are all over that. And back to work with a man advantage. Go the Steelhawks. Pfeiffer at the top. Working with Ferris. Keenan setting the screen. Pfeiffer ducks in. Wrong stick side though. So angles limited. And an easy save made there by Brown, who will air it out. Looking for Tagori, intercepted. Lidstone had it, it sat there. Tompkinson will scoop it up. Looking for Tagori, beauty pass. Tagori, twister, what a play. Wow, 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 wow. That's some fine lacrosse right there. Boy, oh boy, between Tompkinson's effort, Tagori sliding into the opening. Man, and the twister finish, that was a beauty. Can see there, and I don't even think Caleb Martin could believe that, as you could see him striking a pose. He doesn't think that even went in. But Josh Tagori stepping up with his first of the game, and it's 9-8. So a shorthanded marker for Oshawa. And we'll see now, with 1.5 minutes to go in the power play, if Whitby can answer and cancel that one out, restore that two-goal cushion. Third quarter winding down. So you talked about composure with the Outlaws. This Whitby team, chock full of it. Osborne trying to create the angle. Osborne attacking, fake, top corner, ring my bell, one post to the other. Liam Osborne, money in the bank. Fourth goal of the game, first power play goal for the Steelhawks, and this is what I'm talking about here. Composure, execution. Osborne takes what the defense gives him, and if you sag back, he'll attack. If you give him that cushion, he'll take the shot, and that one off both posts and in. So with 54.7 seconds left, Whippy answered the bell there, and now a chance for Oshawa to get that late possession. They come away with it. Millsap, he's done a great job. Takes a gut, stripped, and it's going to be an 8-second count. And that's going to belong to the Steelhawks. Boyd. So Whippy now is not going to be in any hurry. They're going to wait. Boyd trying to work his way in. And I tell you, too much bounce on that ounce. Deep pocket in that stick for Boyd. And now Oshawa's going to try to work it and probably call a timeout would be my guess. St. John over the line. St. John head down. He'll loft it back out. So it looks like they're going to go for the final possession right here. Outlaws, St. John, skip, Atwood. Skip, inside, Hague, stop, rebound, loose, goal, in the net. And that was a beauty by Gareth Hague. How you like me now, G. Hague, in the place to be. Look at this. My, oh my. I don't know, I tell you, but if I'm sending out invites, I want Gareth Hague at the party. He seems to be in the right place at the right time, all the time. With 0.8 seconds to play, picks up his fourth. And it's a one-goal game here, heading to the fourth quarter. Couldn't ask for anything more. Championship game, Arena Lacrosse League. 15 minutes to play. We will see who hoists the All Cup. We'll be back with the fourth. Locked and loaded for the fourth corner here. Final quarter of the Arena Lacrosse League 2023-24 season on the line. The winner here, one goal differential between the number one seed and number three seed meeting in the All-East Final. Someone's going to hoist the cup. Someone may shed a tear or two. Either way, all good on both sides as Lidstone goes to work now. He'll look to kick it up. Good job. Bouncer wide of the mark. He'll corral his own rebound. No reset. Five on the shot clock. Good job. Got to get this right on. Looking for Keenan. They can't connect. So instead, it'll go up the other way. And hats off right now to the Oshawa defense. They have put together a solid two quarters and held one of the best team, the best team in the league, down in the score sheet. Hey, tried to tee that up, never got through. And Martin now with a quick outlet pass to McKinnon. McKinnon, Osborne, pocket, Osborne. And he got checked late. So a good job by Sear. And the issue now is going to be how Brown is, because he got part of that collision. And he looks, though, like he's up on his own power. And we'll have to say that he's shaken, not stirred, and he'll be okay. So that is the case. Gives a signal he's all right. And the Oshawa Outlaws now will go to work on offense, but they're going to have to get it over the timeline first. Just a reminder, you can always watch all the Arena Lacrosse League action. Either go to the JVI YouTube channel or visit arenalacrosseleague.ca. And, of course, all the information right there, including information on registration. How do you get in this league? Because it's a pretty good league to be in. Got to have some skill. McNulty zips it across. Looking for Gilroy. Inside, Atwood, and he couldn't connect in the crease. Can't give it back to Atwood as he's still through. St. John, no, to Gilroy. That shot right on. Morgan's going to get it, and he's going to leg it over the timeline. And a good effort by Morgan as he didn't waste a step there. I tell you, he was intense. He'll get it off Boyd. Now we'll zip it down to Osborne. Osborne surveying. Turn the corner. He's tough to handle. Tried to go top shelf, but off the butt of the stick. So using every part of his equipment, Jackson Brown, and it's Ryan Nolan now. Want to send a shout-out, too, to a veteran on the Oshawa lineup in Graham Bergsma. Again, been in this league since the start. We know you're a KG vet. That underhand through the wickets, but that basket right there by Martin. A quick outlet pass to Peroni. Peroni, wrong stick side. He'll take the shot. That basket's a rebound stopped in the crease, the call. And a quick outlet now, Webb. So end-to-end we go here in the fourth. Sear, he'll put on the brakes. Wait for the rest of the offense and give way now. Haig will zip it down to the facilitator. St. John looking up, Atwood. Quick pass, and McNulty had Gilroy wide open. Wasn't able as the stick popped out of his hand, and Haig now, going to turn the corner. Haig shot, and already leaning was Martin. And now McKinnon. He'll slow things up. One goal game here. You know this one's going to come down to the final possession. Good child. Working one-on-one. Nolan on him. Kick out. Duck in. Lidstone tries to shovel. Great save there by Brown. Positioning on the money by both these netminders, and Millsap now slinks through two, gets it to Tagori, and they'll work at the St. John to set up the offense. So expect every possession now to be magnified. St. John, you know he's not going to take that from out there, but he'll take that one just wide of the mark. Rebound, man ahead in Highland. Morgan, he's going to leg it, he's going to go the safe route. And he'll wait for the whippy offense. So like I said, every possession magnified, got to be disciplined. Come out, work some clock, get the best shot you can. Ferris. That one from Fife Dog, who's been quiet in this game. Osborne, going to bail him out. Plenty of time on the reset. Osborne. Ferris. Quick zip. Boyd will look. Fife Dog. Osborne in the middle. Fernandez, his shot. He'll get his own rebound. Look to body his way in on Sear. Quick shot, didn't get through. Rebound, loose in the crease and smothered as Veltman protecting the house back there. Him and Boyd and Gilroy Sorry, Boyd, they'll jump in there, have a few words, and McDulty now will zip it across Atwood. You got to figure that between Haig and unbelievable effort, Haig and Gilray, he stayed steady on the crease, held his own position-wise, posted up, and put it in the back of the net. We're tied 10-10. Look at his work inside the dotted half circle. How about Haig right away there? The spin around gets it. Gilray stays strong, feet set, and puts it up and over Martin to tie this game at 10. Tell you, Josh Gilray's picked the best time to have his finest playoffs. That's his third goal of this game. And now we're going to see who can answer what. 0-0 right now. Both teams with 10 goals apiece, and the net minding has been outstanding at both ends. Keenan, he'll work it over Ferris. The Whippy offense seems to have gone a tad bit quiet. They'll work back to Lidstone. May have to go to their money man in Osborne. Fife Dog stepping up through 2-3. Give me a bark. Hoo-hoo, Fife Dog finally showing up. And it's 11-10. Devin Pfeiffer, you can see here. I said he was quiet, but great fake underneath. Splits two, and another great fake as he caught Brown leaning. Brown almost guessed right. He just was leaning too far, and the shot was too accurate. So Devin Pfeiffer on the board. That's his third goal of the postseason. First here today, though, and Morgan carried that a little too long on the wrong side of his stick. Whippy now back at it. This is where they're dangerous. Osborne trying to add to that lead. Usually in the fourth, with the exception of that one game against Oshawa. Once they get it, they don't give it back. Romanchich teed that up. Loose in the dotted half circle. Losing his stick, but boxing out. Not able to get a hold of it. And here comes Nolan. Nolan with Harluck, they'll wait, and they'll pull it right back out and set up the offense. Atwood, he's been quiet. You almost expect something out of him in his final 9 minutes. Simons, he's been the difference maker. Him and Haig, give and go, gone and went. St. John picked it up, quick shot, gets knocked down, and a chance now, McKinnon's gonna leg it. They don't have the numbers, but out the back door. Boyd looking for the trailer, and a good decision by McKinnon to get it to Lidstone. Lidstone, half boards on the right, finds Pfeiffer, swinging around left side. Good child. Lidstone gets a step, and that's almost a tackle. So up the other way, and a chance now. Webb's going to put the pedal to the middle. Belt shot, wickets closed. Stopped by Caleb Martin. Morgan will race the other way with it now. End to end, these two teams playing some fine lacrosse. It's been an outstanding championship game. Want to welcome our viewers from all over North America watching this one. Romanchich, give and go. What a save by Brown. He kicked out that right toe. Millsap will try to counter the other way. Get something going here for the Outlaws. And if you want to talk about keeping your team in it, that's what Brown has done. He has kept the Outlaws in it single-handedly with his goaltending. Atwood, skip. That shot right in the basket of Conley. Scooped up Boissonneau. And not a headshot because Boissonneau isn't the tallest guy. And I think most guys in this league around the elbow, that's his head area. Conley. I'm not sure Conley may have thought he was playing by himself in the rink with no one around and forgot there were other players. And a good job on the sneak attack. Outlaws will get it over the timeline in Harlech. Chance here. Sear, dump off. Haig, twister. Can't beat Martin. Martin the other way. Weller. Weller in full stride. Weller ducks in. Weller still has it. He'll flip it back out, and Cody Hamley will slow it down. We're under seven here. Championship game. One goal difference. Steelhawks trying to pad this lead. Keenan and Boyd, they'll work the two-man game, work it to the Fife dog. He'll skip up, stop, reverse, spread the middle. Pfeiffer! Give me another park! The Fife dog crew has done it again. Oh, baby, number 19 for the green and white. Standing tall here, second time this quarter. He has split the D and parked it in the back of the net. So two-goal differential restored, second of the game for the Fife dog. And boy, the good cream definitely rises to the top, and that's been evident here in this game. So two-goal lead for Whippy. But with just over 6.5 to play, that's almost a lifetime in this sport. Problem for Whip for Oshawa, though, is that Matt Boissonneau has been dominant in that circle in the second half, and Whippy now controls possession. Ferris looking for an opening. Veltman on him. He'll skip it over. Osborne has room. Tried to size up the bounce. Instead, Ferris will pick it up. And a reset called on the play. So that one just went off the toe of Brown. And now Lidstone. He's going to look in. Ferris, his shot right on the breadbasket. That one, a late hit. No call there on the play. Outlaws, though, will control it. Good job by Leclerc to handle, sorry, Blumberg to handle the short hop. And now St. John. Turnover there, and Ferris will work it the other way. So Oshawa careless with the ball. Ferris trying to make a pay, and he does. So what has Whippy done all season? They capitalize on opportunities, and a turnover leads to a goal at the other end. Some fine transition lacrosse from the league's top team during the regular season, and you could see Ferris as he just rolled in and casually, as casual can be, picked that far corner for his second of the game. Romicic knew he was going to take a hit. Instead, Boissonneau off the draw, gets it back again. So Whippy controls again, now on the run with numbers. Conley, twister, just through the wickets and wide. Keenan will regroup, takes a hit from Nolan, swims his way out of trouble. Keenan looking for the flip. Instead, he'll change direction, go right back. Diving! What a save by Brown! Note that save there, because if Oshawa's able to climb this mountain, that's the reason why. Blumbergs probably should have taken that shot. Got to take advantage of any little nook and cranny you can against this Whippy team. Haig, he's been sensational. St. John has been quietly, effectively good as always. Take it to the half boards. Atwood swings it around. Three on a shot clock. That one wild from Simons. And Whippy now will collect it and expect them to pull it out with Rowan Kelly. So we are in the crunch time now. The lead is 3. Whippy, time on their side. You can bet they'll work the shot clock all the way down here. Be very deliberate unless Liam Osborne gets a chance. And then there is no time. Skip, Ferris, working, Lidstone, inside. Osborne, fake, and good job by Webb. Kept it on the doorstep, though. Laying there was Fernandez, and a shot clock violation. Good piece of officiating there, as you saw Simon D'Souza put the quell on that, and with 4:03 to go, that is going to take us to our final officials timeout. We will take a quick break. We'll be back. So the clock will continue to tick down on the Oshawa Outlaws. The Whippy Steelhawks, 4 minutes, 3 seconds away from hoisting the All Cup and becoming the first repeat champions in the Arena Lacrosse League. The Oshawa Outlaws trying to climb the mountain and become the first team to repeat as Arena Lacrosse League champions. Atwood was swinging around to St. John. This is when the hurry up offense got to go into play. Backhand try, what a save there by Martin as he read that well. And in the crease, the call here, not sure if it's gonna be a slash, that's the call, and who it's gonna go on. Judging by the way Jeff McNulty is reacting, it's gonna go on Whippy, and it's gonna give the Outlaws. So John Leclerc will go for slashing. Oshawa with their most valuable power play opportunity of the game here. A must score. The quicker they can score, the better. As time a factor. Simons, they'll work it around, and there's something to be said about this whole working around in the fourth quarter when you need to be efficient on time. Murphy, St. John, underhand! John St. John, the master facilitator, the recipient. 13-11. So just what they wanted, a good quick power play goal. They did work it around the horn, but this is a St. John veteran player taking what's given. You see where he takes the pass and where he actually lets go of the shot, the difference. Outside of the dotted circle for the pass, moves in for the shot and the finish. First of the game for St. John. That's his eighth of the postseason. I don't know how many helpers he has, but I imagine there's a lot. So Whippy now clinging to the two-goal advantage. Team's back to full strength here, and now they're going to have to be efficient. Trying to close the book on a storied season. Boyd gets a screen. Boyd, he'll tiptoe around. Seven on the shot clock. Works it down, they cough it up. Whippy looking like they're playing a little keep away, and that's not the way to go against Oshawa. That's what happened last time, and the Outlaws pulled the carpet out from under them. See here what happens and what unfolds. Under 3 minutes, St. John. Simons, they'll work it to Atwood. Still 5-on-5. 10 on the shot clock. St. John, quick pass inside. Atwood was covered, and now Whippy's going to move it up. It's going to be McKinnon. He's going to go in alone. McKinnon. And he's stopped by Brown. Big save there by Jackson Brown. And we're going to have a timeout called. And the Oshawa Outlaws with 2:21 to play. And everyone in the building on the edge of their seat. As you got to figure, if you're the Oshawa Outlaws coming into this scenario, you're going to want to put as much pressure as you can, be as efficient as you can on offense. Try to get something this possession. If you don't get something this possession, you certainly have to stop Whippy from scoring at the other end. If you're the Steelhawks, you're looking to spread the floor, work that shot clock down to say around 10, and then go to work, take your chances, hit or miss. But the way Brown has been playing and the way Martin's been playing, these goaltenders have been locked down good here in this game. It has been an outstanding Arena Lacrosse League Championship game. The playoffs, as usual, this the seventh season, the seventh time the playoffs have rocked the house. So it's going to be Josh Gilray now that's going to do the inbounds. And net's empty at the Oshawa end, so they're going to try to be as efficient as possible and go to work. Here we go. Money time. Money time it is. Gilray at the top. Interchange. St. John. No look. Atwood. They'll work it two-man. St. John now surveying. Haig has some room. No look. Gilray tried to go over the top. St. John pick it up. No reset. Inside Atwood. Couldn't connect. Dying seconds. And through the crease, the call. So we're under 2 minutes possession to the Steelhawks. Roman Chich Osborne, back of the net. I told you about Liam Osborne. I kid you not. The captain wears the C for a reason. You blink, it's in the back of the net. Liam Osborne has been the man. Great look, and he got Brown, opened up the five hole, and that's exactly where it went. And for Liam Osborne, career high championship, five goals this game. And he has been the difference. And Storrs now, Boyd couldn't, sorry, Peroni couldn't haul that in, but time still on the side of the Steelhawks. And there's a prime example where when you have a Matt Boissonneau dominant in that faceoff circle, possession, two-thirds of the game. Osborne, he's going to get a step on Veltman. Osborne, what a save by Brown. Rebound, shoveled again, Brown. And you can't knock anything as far as the goaltending in this game. Millsap keeps the legs going. He dodges three, checks, he moves up in. Millsap, why not, Millsap? That one, too much bounce on the ounce. Going the other way, and frustration as Conley, Millsap probably didn't like the way he was treated, as I'd say that Conley hasn't been the most gracious host this entire game. So I think cooler heads are going to prevail. And he'll head to the penalty box for sure. So just to note that doing the running back and forth is not Jackson Brown. They're saving him for playing net. It's actually Ryan Schutzkowski that has been doing the legwork. And that's a long run in the fourth quarter for any netminder with all that gear on. Special shout out, of course, to Vince Longboat and his lovely wife here again today at the track, taking in this outstanding game. So the Whippy Steelhawks looks like they will be coincidental minors, as the only issue though, so we got a dead ball, two dead ball fouls on that side, one dead ball foul on the Oshawa side, so it'll be a 6-on-4 for Oshawa. And this boy, eerily similar to the last time these two teams met. Here we go. Murphy, St. John, lets it go. Stop. And Martin will get it. He may air it out. He may air that one out. And he does, but into the corner. Kelly's going to run it down. Webb gets it. And the pressure. Got to go the full length. Under a minute to go. Going to have to hurry. You don't have time. Simons. Murphy. Dump. Oh, and I can't believe Haig missed the open net on a quick stick. And that's going to go back. Peroni battles for it. Gilray scoops it. Gilray. Three on the shot clock. Going to have to do something. And that one goes off Storrs, but off the mesh. And will stay right here. So you talk about a fortuitous bounce. That was it. Outlaw still light. 30 seconds. Simons stopped by Martin. St. John going to run this one down. Gilray. Gilray over top of the net. Just missed. Whippy's going to come away with it, and they're going to call a timeout, and the Whippy Steelhawks have possession, control, and the lead here with 18.2 seconds. So a timeout called, and that will give us a chance to take a quick breath before we wrap things up. You're watching the Arena Lacrosse League Championship game on the JVI Network. So here we go. Here we are. Final seconds in the Arena Lacrosse League 2023-24 season on the line. The Whippy Steelhawks, 18.2 seconds away from hoisting the cup. They have possession, but it's going to be some work now. Oshawa's going to put on the press, and Tagori and Murphy are going to pressure. It's going to be flipped up and over the line and deep into the corner. That's what you do if you're Whippy, and that's the KG veterans. Time is going to wind down. The Oshawa Outlaws are going to come up just a wee bit short here. The Whippy Steelhawks, as Murphy with 1.9 pockets it and makes it 14-12. So Austin Murphy playing to the end, fourth of the postseason, and just a good bounce shot far side. But I imagine Caleb Martin's not going to worry too much about that. Outlaws, 3-for-4 on the power play, but just 1.9. And Whippy Steelhawks, you could see already pre-celebration. And that will do it, the buzzer. The Whippy Steelhawks have completed a dream season, 13-1 regular season, 3-0 in the playoffs, including the championship, the 2023-24 Arena Lacrosse League East champions are the Whippy Steelhawks. So there you have it. The Whippy Steelhawks have completed the 2023-24 Arena Lacrosse League season. And as you see there, head coach Joel Johnson, and this will take, we'll take a special moment here. We'll take a special moment here, and Joel Johnson dedicated this game to his late dad, Barry Johnson, who passed away after starting the Steelhawks team franchise. So this, of course, something special for head coach Joel Johnson, and we want to congratulate him in his first season in the Arena Lacrosse League. We want to thank the Whippy Steelhawks. We, of course, want to say rest in peace, Mr. Barry Johnson. Both teams should be congratulated and commended. Outstanding playoffs. The Oshawa Outlaws struggled down the stretch of the regular season. They regroup. They put together their two finest games. You add this, their three best games of the season, and they can hang their heads high. They are one of the class acts here in the Arena Lacrosse League. We are extremely glad to have them, as we'll have both teams line up for the player presentations after we shake hands. We will take a quick break, and we will come back with the trophy presentation here at the track. Welcome back, and We're going to send it downstairs to the carpet. League president, Mr. Paul St. John. So there you have it, the Whippy Steelhawks hoisting the cup for the second time in team history and league history. And this, of course, the final broadcast of this 2023-24 Arena Lacrosse League season. And that'll give us a chance, of course, to thank our coaches. I already did that. We want to thank our players for their commitment, their dedication, their time. Want to thank, of course, the officials in the league. They're always outstanding. Thank you for what you guys put up with and still continue to come and do the best you do here. All the volunteers that come and work tirelessly, their pay, well, there isn't any. It's all for the love of the game. We want to thank them for that. JVI Productions and their commitment to the Arena Lacrosse League, always top-notch, top-notch crew, top-notch broadcast, always. For League President Paul St. John, I want to thank all our viewers out there. I'm Lance Wynn. Thanks for joining us. We look forward to seeing you. 2024-25 Arena Lacrosse League season. From the Toronto Rock Athletic Center, we say Happy Easter. And we'll see you next time.